I was in the wrong area at the wrong time. I was in Avondale, Randon Road, and this wasn't what building that drugs was around the area. And I was in the hallway. The police come in the hallway, and I'm in the hallway. And they asked me what I was doing in the hallway, and I said I was visiting some friends. So they arrested me and charged me with trafficking cocaine. And I didn't have no money on me. I had no crack on me or nothing. They found some stuff out in the hallway on somebody's building or whatever. And they said it was mine. And I'm like, I had no money or nothing. Man, I was looking for something. And they charged me with drug abuse, and sent me to jail for 6 months. I was like this. I was on the go, and I caught an ulcer from going so much, to the point that I fell out in the streets in one of the hills. I had been up like 10 days, 12 days. I fell out because I was done anyway. I was done. I was giving up on life then. I was ready to go. And I fell out in one of the hills, and they called the police. I had got so tired of being sick and crazy and life not giving me what I wanted and things going the wrong way. And I was destined to die, you know, I was trying to die. And the Lord wouldn't let me die. He wouldn't let me die. I wanted to die because I was just tired of what I became and tired of what I was doing. And it seemed like everything was going the wrong way, you know, in life. And so I was, you know, I was trying to contemplate, you know, killing myself, but you know, I came into that church and I was looking pretty bad, you know, and a lot of people were looking at me like, you know, what is he doing here? What's going on with him? And I was coming to church like anybody else, and you know, when you come to God, you have to come as you are. If you can get it together before you get to church, then you may not need God, you know. But you know, I was like, I was coming to church like everybody else, but then everybody was looking at me like there was a problem with it, me coming to church like them. But I'm like a very young in my recovery. I got my first job with John Falcone, as long as he took drug tests and for working with his kids. He said, I'm going to take a drug test with you whenever I want to. As long as you can stay clean, you can work with my kids. And he was paying me $150 a week. So, and I worked with John Falcone for like about maybe a year. And then Buddy Rosa decided that he was going to open up a couple of gyms in Cincinnati. So Buddy opened up a couple of gyms in Millville. In Millville, and he opened one up in Mount Auburn. And then I started working for Buddy LaRosa for the Golden Gloves. And I did that for like, you know, I took urine tests. Every job that I had to take urine tests. And I took urine tests for like 3 or 4 years of working with the Golden Glove youth. Wow, you know, it was one of the greatest moments of my life. But, you know, what made it really sad in 96, and my mom died in 96. I wanted my mom to see me going to the Hall of Fame. My mom had witnessed my ups and witnessed my downs. And, you know, for her to see something like this after all my ups and downs, then I get inducted into the Hall of Fame. And for her to see that would have been just awesome. Really, really, been really awesome. And I think she died before I went in the Hall of Fame, like a week before I went in the Hall of Fame. But I want her to see that so much because, you know, life can turn around for you overnight if you're doing the right thing, you know. And to go into the Hall of Fame at that particular time in my life was just the right thing to happen for me. Opened a lot of doors. Didn't, you know, let the public see me again. Because with 220 fights and I had about 150 knockouts. And in my pro fights, I had 40 fights, 35 knockouts. So, you know, I had 11 title fights out of that 40 fights. I had a real good career. I had a real good thing going on with me. And I feel real comfortable about what I had accomplished. I think it was all worth it. You know, I think, you know, going through my ups and downs is part of life, but what God has made me now, it's been all worth it. You know, it's been really worth it to be a man of God and to be able to share with young people some experiences that I've been through so they won't have to go through it.
And Aaron Pryor walked in, slim as can be, cut as can be. He was a welterweight champ, walked in with the belt on. They let me get in the ring with Aaron. And man, they let me throw punches at Aaron. And I think that's what influenced me to box. When they let me throw punches at the champ of the world, that brought a lot of influence in my life. He was so fast, I couldn't see him there.
Say the prayer, you know, as I walk through the shadow of the valley of death, I shall fear no man but God, fear no evil, and them things of that nature prior to walking to the ring. I just thought about them things, man, but I had extraordinary capabilities to overcome certain situations, but this one I just couldn't pull, you know? I just couldn't pull it. And I know I got fans, and I know I owe my fans a lot. I owe them a lot. And I ain't wanna let my fans down still today. I still don't wanna let them down. I asked Don for $1 million, but he gave me a deal out of 250,000. But I'm out of that deal after fighting Marquez. I ended up coming home, no less than 30,000. Owning the IRS 100-something thousand. And that promiscuous lifestyle I was living came back on me, you know? It came back on me because I didn't handle a loss right. It was a rape charge that I was accused for, and how you twist that bottle or that 40-ounce, that you can twist it with one twist. Don't have to, you know, hit that cap twist. 16 years old, I had caught a case which involved with me to hand this undercover about these 6 bags of marijuana, this marijuana, and give it to him and just get the money and so forth and come back upstairs, and this was my experience.
Everywhere I went, everywhere my mother moved, we had to fight. If you move in a different neighborhood, you go to school, you bump somebody wrong, you gotta fight. Look like every place I can remember going on with Rose High School in the football field, and everybody surrounding just to see us fight. And I'm giving him whooping like he stole something. In order to be a heavyweight champion, you got to sign with Don. If you didn't sign with Don at them time, Don had all the heavyweight. I actually think about going somewhere with a person, buying 10 keys, and got so high that I had was when I went to penitentiary. Now, for all of you youngsters out there that think y'all rolling, that y'all high rolling and things like that, well, you know what? I had the first cell phone.
I told you then, drugs is not the way to make it. You can't make it on selling drugs. You ain't gonna make it. You know, I told you prior to then, you know, here it is now, 2010.